Facebook and YouTube tonight. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. We have an awesome performance tonight with our good old friend Paul Keen and our new friend Greg Jones. We're going to get it over to the stage in just a minute, but I wanted to let you know we are trying to raise a little bit of money for the Kennett Flash tonight. Not a lot, just a little bit. We want to cover the costs of this performance this evening, and we would like to ask, we're asking if you can help us do that. Please, a suggested donation of just $15 helps us make this show happen. We're trying to raise $300 for the Kennett Flash simply to cover the cost of producing this stream. So if you can do that, that would be awesome. You can go to kennettflash.org/donate, kennettflash.org/donate to make a donation to the Flash this evening. Paul and Greg are also accepting donations this evening. They're essentially donating their performance to the Kennett Flash tonight, and we want to ask you to support them as well. During the performance and in the comment section on Facebook and YouTube, you can see links on how to donate to them via Venmo this evening. Please take the time to make a donation to Paul and Greg tonight. Please take the time to support this stream as well by donating to the Kennett Flash. Again, suggest a donation of $15, but whatever you can do, 5 or 10, maybe a couple people are watching, maybe you can do 30 tonight to the Flash, but don't forget the guys, maybe $15 across the board to each, the Flash, Greg, and Paul. That would be a huge, huge help tonight, and a big thank you from us if you could do that. I have a lot to tell you about what's been going on in the world of the Flash, what we have planned for the later this spring and summer. But I want to get to some music. We want to start the show with some music. Let's throw it over the stage. I think we're starting with Paul. Paul, play some tunes for us. Thank you.
In the backseat of your mind, you've been sitting all the time, painting pictures of your life, and you can only see the heart. Hard time, thinking everything's the end. Your last penny has been spent. You're crying, why not me instead? You're the jealous kind. But you got me, and babe, I'll never fall asleep. You got me, can't you see 3 feet in front of your face? You get me. Can I whisper really clear in your silver tin can ear? Cause you know that's why I'm here. When you think it's getting way too hard, come on, don't you be so strange. Cause you know it's gonna change. We should be waiting for the blue sky, even though it's gonna rain. Cause you got me, and babe, I'll never fall asleep. You got me, can't you see 3 feet in front of your face? You got me. I know it takes time. I think you're gonna try to put the pieces back from where they came. You got me, you got me. And babe, I never fall asleep. You got me, you got me, you got me. Thank you, thank you. All right, so that was an old one. I probably wrote that in like 2006 or something. This is a newer one called I Wanna Know Everything. That song's about Wikipedia, because I always want to know everything.
That's awesome. Good song.
All right. So we're doing like 3 and 3 and maybe 2 and 2 every once in a while. This is an old one called Let It Roll. Well, the good time never lasts, and the bad time never stays. Let it roll, baby, let it roll, let it roll. Well, you're walking down the road, you might be falling right on your face. Let it roll, baby, let it roll, let it roll. Come on, baby, put your dress on tight. Got some money, we're going out tonight. We're gonna pay them dues. We're gonna walk them blues away. Ain't no sense in crying. Ain't no such thing about yesterday. Well, the good time never lasts, and the bad time never stays. Let it roll, baby, let it roll, let it roll. Well, you're walking down the road, your mouth is falling right on your face. Let it roll, baby, let it roll, let it roll. Come on, sugar, why you look so sad? Best damn woman that I ever had. You're gonna pay them dues, we're gonna walk them blues away. Ain't no sense in crying. Ain't no such thing about yesterday. Well, the good time never lasts, and the bad time never stays. Let it roll, baby, let it roll, let it roll. Well, you're walking down the road, your mouth is falling right on your face. Let it roll, baby, let it roll, let it roll.
Hey, good evening, everybody. Thanks to The Flash for having me. Thanks for Paul for bringing me on in this one. It's a pleasure to be here. It's a pleasure playing for everybody tonight. This first song is called From the Crash, and it's written about a interesting car accident that I got into several years ago.
Grinding down the guardrail, sparks are flying. Just a few miles or more to go. Windows down and one eye open. Lining up tire tracks in the snow. Then I found myself just gliding. A flash of white, then black, then white. It's 3 o'clock in the morning. Not another car in sight. And then crash. Chevrolet 1989, headed northbound 95. Red truck to a redhead girl. We're damn lucky to be alive, 'cause they found themselves just gliding. I switched off the cruise control. It's 3 o'clock in the morning. The truck starts to roll from the crash. From the crash. Well, time stood on end. The rear view mirror was upside down. Well, gasoline poured down the side. Pulled her through the windshield wide open from the crash. From the crash.
Thank you very much. Thanks. Thanks, y'all. Thank you. This next song is called Katie's Waltz. I wrote it about my niece, the day I met my niece, the day she was born, or the day I met her, but it was a couple days after she was born. It's called Katie's Waltz.
Well, how am I supposed to be the one you love? And how can I refrain from being the hated? And who'd you like to see above the man? Says, and who'd you like me to be? Well, Great Britain's gone to the wayside. Let's leave it all behind. Leave it for your mind's eye. 'Cause those times are gone, but not forgotten. And maybe there will be another time for me, and maybe then we'll see we're all up for ashes to ashes. Thank you. And untie my laces and get dizzy just for fun and run away. For hours and hours and not get winded when war was just a game. It ended. Well, Great Britain's gone to the wayside. Let's leave it all behind. Leave it for your mind's eye. 'Cause those times are gone, but not forgotten. Let's leave it all behind. Leave it for your mind's eye. 'Cause those times are gone, but not forgotten. Maybe there will be another time for me. Maybe then we'll see we're all up for ashes to ashes.
Thank you very much. Thanks. I'm spitting all over the place. Sorry, y'all. It's what I do. So this next song is called The Border. I wrote this song after watching a documentary about border jumpers and their plight. So
throw your cards down on the table and show your hand to me. There's far too much for me to gamble and lose it all to thee. Awake when I should be sleeping, tied up when I could be free. Come tonight, my friend, down to the border and slip right under with me. You slip right under with me. Sometimes I can see so clearly. Other times it appears to be that my eyes don't work to my liking when they play these tricks. These dirty little tricks on me. Awake to find I'm still sleeping. I glide through this reverie. Fly down the tracks that lead straight into the gold mine. I cross the border with you if you cross the border with me. Thank you. opportunity knocks, then walks away. I don't know when, and I don't know why, but some people win, 'cause others don't try. So tonight, the time will be, we'll go for coffee, then we'll run out and see, across the border, over the line, we'll slip past the guards to the other side. Throw your hands up to the sky and keep them still as can be. Keep them where we can see them.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thanks. That was my three. Now you're on to your...
There's talking.
Talking.
There is talking.
The voice of God.
The voice of God.
My friend texted me to let me know the Ten Commandments was on.
There you go.
I'm okay with missing it. That's all right. I've seen that movie 10,000 times when I was a kid. We're back. I'm Andrew. You're you. You're at home watching on Facebook. You're watching on YouTube. I'm going to talk to the guys in just a little bit and ask them some questions, but I want to talk to you first, and I want to ask you if you've made a donation yet to the Kennett Flash this evening, if you've made a donation to the artists yet this evening. You can support the Kennett Flash very easily, and I'm going to try this again. I tried this last night. It didn't work so well, but I know it's going to work better tonight. Look at the bottom of the screen. KennettFlash.org/donate. KennettFlash.org/donate. We're asking for a donation of $15 to the Kennett Flash tonight. We're hoping to get 20 of those. We're hoping to raise $300 for the Kennett Flash tonight. And it's really simply to cover the costs of our production team tonight, the people who come in to help make this event possible for you at home. If we can cover those costs, some of the other money we've been able to raise over the past couple months goes where it's most needed. And you are paying to tune in tonight. It's a pretty simple deal. It's easy, $15. You wanna donate $5, you wanna donate $10, you can do that, no problem. You have a couple people watching, you wanna donate $30, you can do that, no problem. But please, when you make that donation to the Kennett Flash, don't forget Paul and Greg. You've already seen the links on the screen throughout the performance. They're in the comments section of Facebook and YouTube, and certainly they're going to be on the screen much more throughout the rest of the show. For those of you tuning in for the first time tonight or tuning in for the first time in a while, I want to give you an update of what's going on with the Kennett Flash, and I want to throw out a couple thank yous right at the top. I mentioned this last night, if you happened to watch last night, August, September, October, those were some crazy months here at the Kennett Flash. I was scared to death about what was going to happen with the future of this organization. And it's really from the support of a couple different places in November and December that we're here. That's the reason why we're here right now. And I want to thank those people and places. I want to thank the Live Music Society. Live Music Society decided to grant 20 venues, just 20 venues in the country, an award in November. And the Kennett Flash was one of just 20 venues that they decided was among the most in need and among the most in need of being preserved. Thank you to the Live Music Society for supporting the Kennett Flash. Thank you to the Chester County Community Foundation. Via the CARES Act, they granted the Kennett Flash money in December. Thank you to the Chester County Community Foundation. Thank you to NEVA, the National Independent Venue Association, for your support of the Kennett Flash. The Kennett Flash is a proud member of the National Independent Venue Association. And in December, through legislation through months and months. You guys might remember this if you tuned in for Dead Flowers over the summer. We were pushing for months and months to get this legislation passed. It passed in December, but guess what? We have not seen that Save Our Stages money yet. The applications open this week, finally, coming up this week, those applications open. And we are hopeful that that'll be the bridge for us to reopen again. But in the meantime, the National Independent Venue Association made a significant grant to the Kennett Flash in December. And we are grateful to them for their support of the Kennett Flash. And this does not go without saying. The key cog in all of this is you guys. You guys at home who have supported the Kennett Flash throughout this whole time. If you guys weren't there, if you guys weren't donating to performances just like this one, we wouldn't have been able to go to organizations like the Live Music Society or to the National Independent Venue Association and say, hey, we have something worthy of preserving here. We have something where we've built a community that is already invested, and we don't want to lose that. Because we were able to say those things, those organizations said, yeah, you're getting that support in those other places. There's a whole bunch of people who don't want to see you go away. We're going to help you as well. And it's that collective across the board with everybody helping that we were able to get to where we are right now. And that's you at home making donations to performances just like this one. So thank you for your support of the Kennett Flash. Thank you for making a donation this evening at kennettflash.org/donate. All right, so now it's the interview portion of the show, and the guys aren't prepared for this at all. I'm very minorly prepared, but this is gonna be exciting. So and I understand I need to kind of move. There's a new position I need to stand in tonight, so we're going to try that right now. Watch this. All right. Am I in the correct position, Chip? He's given me a thumbs up, so I'm in the correct position. I see Paul right in front of me, so I'll start with Paul. Paul, I have a series of words written down here, okay. And... you know, I'm just going to jump around. We're going to start with Kennett Square. I have Kennett Square written down. Did you grow up in Kennett Square?
I did. I went to Unionville High School, though. So you, like,
that counts, sort of.
I didn't go to Kennett High School. Yeah, so.
Unionville, class of?
97.
Class of 97.
Yeah.
Wow, good for you. Good for you.
Okay.
So
I graduated. Yeah.
You graduated. Yeah. Yeah. So at some point you move on from Unionville, Kennett Square area, all that kind of stuff, and you move up to Philadelphia, right?
I do. Yeah.
So that happened, right?
It did. Yeah. I moved to Westchester, then I moved to West Philly.
Okay, and, let's before we get to West Philly, we'll stop in Westchester for just a second.
Okay, let's take
because I bet you there's a story somewhere. Pawn Shop Roses also is one of your main gigs. There's a band called the Pawn Shop Roses. What year did the Pawn Shop Roses form?
We're going to say 2002.
2002. So we're coming on the 20th anniversary of the Pawn Shop Roses. Is it the original lineup?
It is not the original lineup.
Will you have a reunion show with the original lineup?
We'd like to have some of the guys.
Okay.
To come back and maybe do like a reunion show.
Okay.
Depending on COVID.
I mean, we still got another year. We still got till next year. But
We'd like to bring...
no pressure.
There's a guy, Chad Miller... Okay. Who went to Westchester University, who started, we were called Kush at first.
Oh, okay. Chase. So are you including the Kush history in that?
Well,
he
helped change the name to Pawn Shop Roses, and then we did that. Kevin Bentley has been there since 2002, so I feel like we're doing, you know, when did Pawn Shop Roses start? We're going to say... 2002.
Well, here's what I wanted to ask because
it's hard to know.
Because I'm trying to remember, and I think I'm remembering correctly. I don't remember the year Rex's closed, but I'm guessing you might have played at Rex's with Pawn Shop Roses or one of your projects.
We did.
Tell me a Westchester story.
Well, I think we were called Kush at the time. We played a place called the Hard Bean Cafe on High Street, which I'm sure it's not there anymore. I don't even know what
it is
now.
There was Fenario's too, but
we played Fenario as well. Yeah, yeah.
So, but you don't have an awesome Rex's story. Like, you didn't open
Well, there was a Rex's story
so-and-so.
Where we were underage and we tried to we tried to sign up for the open mic and they were giving us trouble and, you know, ended up signing up. It kind of was a bad performance.
So that's a Rex's story. That counts. That counts. Did you spend any significant time in Rex's, or it's a little bit before your time?
It was before we were 21, really.
Okay.
Right. So, yeah.
Well, that's all right. Okay. Moving on.
But we played Hard Bean Cafe and Fenario because we were under 21.
I see. Right. That makes sense. So then you get to West Philly, and the band is evolving and all this kind of stuff. You guys have a bit of a history. A lot of recordings released, a lot of Pawn Shop Roses recordings out there?
We have three albums.
What is the definitive Pawn Shop Roses record?
I'd like to say Let It Roll. But with a new format, I'd like to say Solid Gold. So Let It Roll came out in like 2007, I think. Solid Gold came out maybe 2008 or 2010. I can't remember.
Tell me, a definitive in the peak of the band. Not that you're gone off the other end now, but right. You're still at that peak, right? But yeah. Tell me, when does Pawn Shop Roses? When are you like, man, I'm gonna do this for a long time because this is just hitting on all cylinders. This show, this song, this experience. What was it with Pawn Shop Roses that became...
It was probably like 2005, 2006. We won a YouTube contest, went to New York. You know, they set us up in a big hotel, and we went on Good Morning America, and it was like, you know...
This is cool. This is a good story. Yeah, I've heard parts of this story before. So that's probably still a little earlier in the YouTube era.
It is. It's almost like maybe 2 or 3 years after YouTube was like formed or you know started.
And so what happens? What was the big thing that came out of that? Was it just you played Good Morning America? Was it a contest to play Good Morning America, or was it we're going to give you $1 million in a recording contract with whoever?
It was just basically a contest where. Bands would submit videos. I think originally it was supposed to be one video. You know, one video would win, but they saw a bunch of different videos, and it was like a live video. It was a scripted video. It was a, whatever. So they decided to change the format to, okay, maybe we'll do like best live video, best scripted video, best whatever. So we won best live video, which was recorded at Grape Street.
Was that a home base for you guys?
We lived in Manayunk for a little bit. Yeah.
Okay. Cool. So what was the big prize from that?
It was a weekend hanging out with Google and YouTube and trying to push your music and trying to talk to some people that play songs and like Grey's Anatomy or stuff like that. But what kind of stunk was that we didn't have music out. So it's like we show up, we're like,
hey. So back in that time period, you'd want to hand a CD to somebody.
We would like to have a CD. We'd like to have like some sort of like press kit.
Sure.
We had no press kit.
Yeah.
So that kind of.
So.
But we did sign to a small record label called Earvolution that put out Let It Roll.
Well, there you go. There you go. So through that, you were able to kind of get the first album financed and out and all this kind of stuff.
Right, yeah.
Well, that's good. That's a good story. That counts. So at a certain point, you wanted to move on from the band, but you wanted to kind of stretch your wings like you are tonight more kind of on your own. And you wanted to record some songs on your own, and you get hooked up with a guy named Pete Donnelly. right? So this is, I mean...
Well, actually, Pete Donnelly, he produced Let It Roll as well.
Oh, well, there you go. Okay, okay.
But I kind of came back to Pete and said, hey, man, like, I'd like to do a solo album.
Maybe like 5 years ago or something like that?
Yeah, 5 or 6, yeah.
Okay. And tell the audience at home about Pete Donnelly.
So Pete Donnelly is in a band called The Figs, plays bass and sings. He also plays with NRBQ sometimes and, you know, a couple other great bands.
And what is, with the solo record in particular, you've released one solo record now?
I have, yeah.
And what was that experience like? What I mean, Pete is he writing or is he just playing with you?
Well,
so,
yeah, he had a studio in New Jersey, a basement studio in his house. And went down, I did like a lot of acoustic stuff to a click. He would go to a keyboard, bang out a beat. We would do that. We would take it to some other people. They would play. Pete would play bass. He would play some drums. We would go into Kawari Sound and have Pawn Shop come in. And, you know, it was like all over the place like that, but...
So you said have Pawn Shop come in. So almost like a Tom Petty thing when he records his solo records and then brings
right,
the Heartbreakers
yeah,
in to play on his records.
Yeah, it's like Mike Campbell, come on.
Yeah. So Mike Campbell played on your record. That's pretty
he did
cool.
not. It was more like Kevin Bentley and Justin Monteleone, but yeah.
So my understanding is Pawn Shop Roses are getting ready to go back in the studio.
We are, actually.
First time in how long?
Oh, man. Since the solo album, which would be 5 or 6 years ago, officially Pawn Shop Roses, I would say, 10 years?
So it's time.
It's definitely time.
How many songs do you have already? Or are you going to write in the studio, or what's the plan?
We have 4 songs. We're probably going to go there, set up, play live, try to bang out 4 songs live, get a good drum sound, get a good band sound, maybe take it home, you know, layer over some stuff like overdub, you know. Or if we did it well enough in the studio, we might keep a lot of stuff as well.
So what's the ultimate goal? To have a CD, to have a 12-inch record, to have a, you know, a full-length record, to just have songs you can sell digitally, to have something you can market for Grey's Anatomy. You're like, what? Seriously, though, what are
when
you
When did Grey's
to do
Anatomy
right
get
now?
Canceled? I don't even know.
I have no idea.
Is it still on air? Like, is it still?
I don't know. But what are you trying to do with this? What's the plan?
Or
are you just, it's been so long, you just want to get back in the studio and do it for you?
Definitely a digital EP would be good. You know, maybe get on XBN, maybe, who knows? You know.
Get some shows out of it, you know, that
of course,
kind of thing.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, cool. Hey, big CD release show at The Flash.
We could do that. That might work, yeah.
All right. So, you know, I don't want to be remiss and ignore Greg. Greg is here, and we want to find out all about Greg. Greg, you're originally from New York?
Yes, originally, yeah.
And then you're in Jersey now?
Yes.
South Jersey over
South
Bridge?
South Jersey. Swedesboro, New Jersey.
So 322 Commodore Barry?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
Very good. You know your stuff.
What brings you to New Jersey? When does that happen?
I fell in love with a Jersey girl.
How'd you do that?
I don't know. Met her in college. She's awesome.
Okay, where'd you go to college?
On Long Island.
Oh, okay. Yep. Okay. So you fell in love with a girl and you moved back kind of to her neck of the woods?
Yeah.
And my understanding is there's a story about the Monterey Pop Festival or something like
that? Yeah.
So I
didn't play the Monterey Pop Festival.
No, but you saw the Monterey Pop Festival on TV when you were very, very young.
Old? 5.
Okay.
I was watching PBS after like watching Saturday morning cartoons, and they ran a, you know, like a telethon to raise money.
Like we're doing here.
Exactly. And they were going to show the Monterey Pop Festival, and they were doing like these little cut-in clips of all artists that were playing the Pop Festival. And I saw Otis Redding dancing on stage, and I said, that's what I want to do with my whole life.
So
from a very young age, okay, I was about five. That's when this all started for me.
My vision of Otis Redding from the Monterey Pop Festival is he's got some kind of suit on and a microphone in his hand, and he's dancing around and all this kind of stuff.
I don't think I wanted to emulate him. I just wanted to be a performer. I think that's really
you wanted to be on stage.
Correct.
Okay, because I don't see the suit. I see this hat. I see this flannel shirt, I see a guitar, kind of troubadour kind of feel a little bit different. So I don't know a lot about you, but I know a little bit. And it's just, what I've done in all my years of research online and everything. You released an album in 1999.
Yeah.
Tell me about that record and how that came about. Is that just you, or is that you and a band, or what's the story with that record? Because that's a
sordid tale.
I'm trying to.
Yeah.
Give the listeners at home, the watchers at home, kind of a little bit of a backstory of your history.
Sure.
And I know that record, which, geez, 1999, we're going back 22 years.
Yeah, long time.
But that record's an important record in your history.
Yeah, I basically played with a band for a long time, and we were ready to go and record, and then the band kind of dissolved. And I had this momentum going, and I had all these songs. I actually had studio time booked, and I just said, I'm just gonna record an album.
So I did
a lot of the stuff myself, but I invited some friends in, and they helped me out with a lot of things.
And how did that record come out? Are you happy with that still today?
Yeah, I mean it's obviously old, so it's dated. It has a grunge to it.
Do you still play those songs?
I'm going to play one of the songs tonight for sure. Yeah.
Has that song evolved itself?
Does it feel a lot different? It's not the same version of the song whatsoever. Yeah, and there's two songs on the album that have evolved.
But it still feels like you, and that's still a part of you, and you're still trying to tell that story.
Without a doubt, yeah, for sure.
So, I have all these notes here. Solo, band, there's something called Grass and Gravel.
Yeah.
What's Grass and Gravel?
Grass and Gravel is a band that basically formed, I want to say, probably like six years ago at this point. I've been playing together with a good friend of mine named TJ Fry. We've been playing together for 10 years. And we basically put the band together around the two of us. So we basically co-front the band. It's very harmony-driven, three-part harmonies on a lot of the songs. He writes songs, he fronts songs, I write songs, he fronts songs. So
that's a duo project.
Yeah, but it's basically the band. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So you'll play just the two of you and then other shows with a backing band as well?
Correct, yeah.
Okay. But that's separate from your solo stuff, right?
Yeah, I mean, the solo stuff, for me right now, I feel like the solo stuff, even though I'm playing solo tonight, my focus is on my band.
Grass and Gravel?
Yeah, okay. Yeah. So, I mean, as far as I'm concerned, the Greg Jones Project solo stuff is always a part of me. I'm always going to write for myself.
So how much of your set tonight are tunes that you are playing with Grass and Gravel?
Two of them already I have. I think the first two songs. A bunch of them are Grass and Gravel songs.
Okay, so
for sure.
So somebody who hears you tonight is going to get a good idea of the kind of vibe for Grass and Gravel as well.
No doubt. Yeah, for sure.
Good. So if I'm not mistaken, it's not until 2016 that you release another record.
Right.
So a 17-year gap between recording. Why 17 years?
Because
what happened?
I was scared to go into the studio, and I was scared that it wouldn't turn out the way I wanted it to turn out. I didn't have the right head, and I also didn't have the right guys. And then when I started playing with TJ, and we brought other guys in, they really kind of helped to give me the confidence to say, all right, it's time to record these songs.
So tell me how different that record is than the record you recorded 17 years prior. And like, what's listening back to that one today, how different does that make you feel, you know?
I just feel like that the first record was in like post-grunge phase. So it's very, like, as far as I'm concerned, it had very grungy kind of.
Did you cover Limp Bizkit on the first record?
Never. Never.
Did you break stuff?
No, I've never broken anything.
All right. Wait, did I hit on a nerve?
No, that's not even post-grunge, I don't think.
Like, it's not.
Who's post-grunge? Like semi-sonic or something?
No, I feel like post-grunge, you know, like you listen to MMR, God bless MMR, but like there's some bands that sound like grunge, but they're like post-grunge, but they're still grunge, but it's like...
Three Doors Down?
Yes.
Yes.
That's okay. Post-grunge.
Yeah. Okay.
That's a good one. Yeah.
All right.
That was good.
The new metal was a thing, though. So, but
new metal is Limp Bizkit.
Yeah. And that era came after grunge, but that's not post grunge. I see what you're saying. So, I'm sorry, we derailed this conversation.
You're fine.
Genres all.
Yeah. So 2016.
Right.
Tell me something more about this record, about this. I mean, that's your latest recording, right?
No, we just released an EP in 2019, I believe. That was with Grass and Gravel. That was a Grass and Gravel EP. That was the last one.
I mean, but going back to, it's called Volume 1, right?
Correct.
Going back to Volume 1, how is that, to you at this point, is that your definitive recording? Or do you think your definitive recording hasn't come out yet?
As far as I'm concerned, from a solo perspective, Volume 1 is kind of what you described. But I feel like I said before, my focus really is with the band right now. So Grass and Gravel is the one that we just recorded was great. But then we just actually recorded a new single, which is going to drop within the next couple of weeks, which is phenomenal. I love
with
that song.
With Fred Durst.
No Fred Durst. No break stuff.
All right. So, you have a day job, right?
Yeah.
Okay. You're selling houses or something like that. But music is still kind of a part of your regular routine.
It's my primary. I mean, my day job is just a day job. Music is undoubtedly who I am.
Music takes priority.
Without question, yeah.
And the wife is good with that.
We have a great, great marriage, great Perfect. Understanding. Yeah.
I mean, I heard you talking about her with Paul before the show a lot. So
yeah.
That's good. I want to hear some more music.
Yeah, let's do it.
So who's up?
I think I'm up first.
Paul's All right. up for two.
Let's hear some more tunes. Thanks, guys. Thanks for chatting letting us know what's going on.
Yeah, so... I wrote a lot of songs about girls and breakups. So that's... we were probably talking about that in the back.
A lot.
A lot in the back that everyone heard. But that's okay. This is called Not That Proud. This is a newer one. It's going to be on the EP as long as it comes out good. Or well. Listen to sad songs, 'cause I think I might lose it. And I don't wanna listen to love songs, 'cause I already lost you. And every little thing makes me think about every little thing about us. And I can't take not touching you, it's all too much. Every time it gets hard, you go. And it's so quiet here, and my head's so loud. The last we spoke, I couldn't swallow my pride. But the truth is, I'm
not that proud. I just tried to let myself shine, and everyone knew it. I always do well for a while, and somehow I just blew it. And every little thing makes me think about every little thing about us. But I can't take not touching you. It's all too much. Every time it gets hard, you go. It's so quiet here, my head's so loud. The last we spoke, I couldn't swallow my pride. But the truth is, I'm not that proud. Mike Campbell solo here. Every time it gets hard, you go. You go. It's so quiet here, my head's so loud. Swallow my pride, but the truth is, it's so quiet here, my head's so loud. Last we spoke, I couldn't swallow my pride, but the truth is, I'm not that proud.
So, this next one's a very astrology type song. I feel like my family used to do a lot of astrology. We were into that for a little bit. So this is about a Gemini, who might be the female, and this is about a Pisces, who might be the male. Geminis. They are ruled by Mercury. So this is called You Are Mercury Child. Never seen someone so blue-eyed and blue as you. You're like a flash in the sky, zigzag in my eyes. I always enjoy the view. But if you fly so close to the sun, why your hands so cold? You are Mercury child, brilliant and wild. Always try to keep up with you. I miss the girl with a smile just for me. Her dress, her legs, her eyes. Chasing me down, soul so pronounced. These hearts we were born to find. But if you move so fast, how can I follow your path?
you are Mercury, child, brilliant and wild. I tried to keep up with you. I look for your spot in the sky until you disappear. Then I run outside, but you're always trying to hide. Nothing's the same around here. And if you fly so close to the sun, why your hands so cold? You are Mercury, child, brilliant and wild. I tried to keep up with you. Mercury, child, brilliant and wild. I try to keep up with you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Paul. That's good. This song is called House Not Home, and it's about a real estate client that I had an interaction with who discovered that they could not afford to sell their house, and it was a sad exchange, but this is basically almost word for word how the transaction went down, and yeah, so it's called House Not Home.
Am I awake or dreaming as we're scheming to run away? Leave it all behind. Don't lock the door or say goodbye. It's not our fault that the house we bought ain't worth nothing. What we paid for, no more. Don't lock the front door. Don't turn around, don't say goodbye. Goodbye. Hit the road and settle down in a new town and change our names.
Some call it a classic case of run and hide. I call it surviving. As long as I've got me and you've got you, we'll know what to do. And try and keep ourselves together this last time and see things through just like the last time. That's what the sunsets are for. You drive right to them out of the rain. In my rear view mirror, I see pain fade away.
Thank you very much. Thanks. Thanks, everybody. Thanks, guys. This next song No, I'm not going to do that song. Sorry. I'm going to do that later. This song is called Roll Me Over.
Nobody knows the shape I'm in. I'm 90 degrees, I'm four times over, I'm square as sin. I once was a circle rolling through space and time. No beginning or end, I'm in the now all the time. Nobody can roll me over. Nobody can roll me over. I might look kind of small, but I'm as big as a mountain. Eagle fly below me as I'm looking down. There's nothing but clouds and skies above me. I can hear the wind and feel it pushing up against me. But that don't matter now. Nobody can blow me over. Nobody can roll me over. Plant, they grow straight down. keep us grounded. Look like a puddle, but I'm ocean sized. My water runs deep, my crashing waves, my rising tides. Once I was drowning slowly, someone else's sea. I'm crawling to the surface. I can barely even breathe. Nobody can hold me under. Nobody can roll me over. Nobody can roll me over. Nobody can roll me over.
Thank you very much. Thanks, guys. Thank you.
Good stuff.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Greg Jones.
Wonderful. Thank you, Paul Keen.
It's hard to tune out. You're trying to listen to Greg, and you don't want to be like ding, ding, ding.
I know. Which is why I started my song completely out of tune.
All right, so this is going to be on the Pawn Shop Roses EP coming up, which has not been recorded yet, but it's going to be released hopefully this year. This is called "You Drowned Me." She's out, then she's in it. I can't find my way to my own paper bag. I never thought about giving up, but now I'm waving the white flag. I'm so happy you found me, but then you drowned me at the party. I'm sitting here on my fish tank, nothing left in the gas tank. Well, hardly. Yeah. I was born in 1979, somewhere in between X and Y. Where do I fit? How can I get here? I can't find my way out of my own paper bag. I never thought about giving up, but now I'm waving the white flag. I'm so happy you found me, but then you drowned me at the party. I'm sitting here on my fish tank, nothing left in the gas tank. Well, hardly. Thank you.
party. I'm sitting here in my fish tank, nothing left in the gas tank. Well, hardly, babe. I'm so happy you found me, but then you drowned me at the party. I'm sitting here in my fish tank, nothing left in the gas tank.
Thank you. It's an abrupt ending, but I like it. It's good with drums.
All right. So earlier we were talking about the YouTube stuff and the first album, Let It Roll. So this is off of that. This is the first song off the first album. Called Here We Go.
Yeah, your money and go back home is all you ever do. Make yourself nothing here is working out, and you're going back to school. You're living out that dream, cause it's only two. I can't breathe, just sitting around. There's nothing moving underground. You'll come back like a ghost. You change your face and a name, baby, no one knows. I can't breathe, just sitting around. There's nothing moving underground. Any town.
Thank you.
This is the first kind of cowboy song I ever wrote. It's called Working Man's Song. Packed up my life and jumped on a bird to fly. It's just that I became way too comfortable pissing my life away. So I quit my job for more than 9 to 5. And I like it that way. They say, do what you love, and love what you do. Because who you are becomes what you do. I'd like to ride on a wave of adoring fans. Well, that'll be my job, 'cause I just decided that I'll write my songs for your hearts that I've captured. And then you'll applaud, 'cause that's what I'm after. Yeah, that's my true love. I love what I do, because who you are becomes what you do. My true love, I love what I do, because who you are becomes what you do, because who you are becomes what you do. Thank you very much. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much. This next song is off my first album that I recorded in 1999.
Think about where you've been since the last time, and then we'll talk about where you'll be the next time. I sense a splash across my tongue, which crossed my eyes. Then up stepped the preacher man, a little book in his hand, said he's come down to analyze, hypothesize among his little congregation. Until they're clean, thrust that baby's head right under the water. It must be guilty of something. It must be crying. Well, that little bastard, who did he think he was? What's done is done. Then up stepped the preacher man, a little book in his hand, said he's come down to analyze, criticize now. Is that clean? Think about where you've been since the last time, and then we'll talk about where you'll be.
Thank you very much. Thanks. Thank you.
Talking.
Guess who's up?
Nice. God.
I'm here. Thank you, guys. Thank you for tuning in tonight. We got a couple more, and I'll send it back over to the guys in just a minute. I wanted to remind you, now is a great time. You can do this on your phone. It's really easy. KennettFlash.org/donate. KennettFlash.org/donate. $15. Make it happen tonight, guys. We are far short of our minor goal, our small goal, our tiny goal of $300. We would love to see some more donations tonight to get us closer to that goal. If we don't hit it, it's not the end of the world, but we do want these streams to be supported. We find value in what we're doing. This is a very fulfilling thing we're doing, and we get great feedback on what we're doing from people just like you watching at home. And people just like you watching at home have invested in what we're doing. And we're asking you to make a small investment this evening. $15 does it. $5 or $10 helps us along the way. Maybe if a couple people are watching, you can support just a little bit more. The big news, the big news is that starting April 30th, We will be presenting concerts outdoors in Kennett Square. We plan 35 concerts this summer, over the summer months, over the spring and summer months, on the roof of the Kennett Square parking garage. This is a big, 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 big deal. And we want you to be part of it. Those concerts are on sale now. We have about 12 of them up and listed on our website at kennettflash.org. You can pick up tickets now. The Beatlemania show was the first one we announced. That's on Saturday, June 5th, and that's almost sold out. The Beatles on the rooftop. Get those tickets. Make it happen. These shows are going to be COVID-friendly. The size of the space is at least four times what we're dealing with here in the Flash, and we're not going to have more people than we would for a Flash show. So there's going to be plenty, plenty, plenty of space for social distancing. It's going to be very safe, very friendly, awesome concerts, high production values, pyrotechnics, the full nine yards. You know, we're bringing in Metallica's road crew to pull off these shows, and Limp Bizkit's road crew too. It's gonna be awesome.
Break stuff.
So, what's that?
So break stuff.
Yeah, break stuff, man. It's gonna be like Woodstock '99. It's gonna be excellent. So please,
sounds scary.
Support the Kent. What's that?
So that sounds scary. Woodstock '99.
It was a joke. It will be like Woodstock 69 before it rained, you know, before right, the bad drugs.
Very came out. Peaceful.
Yes, very peaceful. Okay. So, but seriously, what I was kind of saying is we want to continue doing these streams. Even when we get outside and do these streams have been such a cool thing. We're learning all the time. We're learning new ways of doing things, and we're upping our production value all the time, and we want to keep bringing them to you. And we want to know that they're supported, and we want to know that you're into them. So let us know. Let us know what you think. Let us know what you want, and support them. KennettFlash.org/donate. KennettFlash.org/donate. $15, $10, $5, whatever you can do. Support the Kennett Flash. Support these streams. We'll see you outside this summer. We're off next weekend. It's crazy. We don't have any shows next weekend. The next live stream, if memory serves correctly, is Cliff Hillis and Cliff Hillis and Ben Arnold in 2 weeks. So we'll be back here for another live stream pretty soon. You know, open mic later this month. All kinds of stuff coming up. You know, but make a donation now. It's time. You guys have enjoyed this show. I know you have. KennettFlash.org/donate. $15. So easy. So easy. How about a couple more songs to end the night on a good note, on a happy note? You guys want to hear some more. I know you do. Who's up, Paul?
I am up.
Play a couple?
Yeah, this is a newer one. I've been doing a lot of new songs tonight because I like to, you know, put that out there. Usually with a band, we would do songs that they all knew and whatever, but I'm doing new stuff.
So you're saving the Limp Bizkit covers, no Limp Bizkit
covers. I am
covers
saving
tonight.
All the, yes.
All right. Maybe a Fred Durst solo song. But
what are some other new metal bands that we can talk about? Some
wow. This is,
I mean,
now it's
Deftones is a good one.
Yeah, Deftones.
You know, but it's a new metal, you know.
Yeah. You know what? I don't remember.
Yeah, I don't remember any of those new metal bands either.
Yeah. No, I do remember. I got one. Mudvayne.
Mudvayne. Wow. Okay.
You know, the bass player for Mudvayne has a new band called Softening the Glare, and they've been here twice, and they're phenomenal. Okay. They're heavy, and it's like heavy metal jazz. It's crazy. In this space especially.
Yeah.
And it's weird because he doesn't paint his face or anything like that. That was their big thing. They painted their faces or bodies or something. But he does take his shirt off at the Flash when he plays.
And it's
really intense. But great, great music. Softening the Glare. Check it out. Anyway.
Cool. I like the diversity of the Kennett Flash, you know.
Yeah. That's my thing. That's something... I don't want it to be one thing. I want to embrace all kinds of art and all kinds of music. So, you know, jazz one weekend, folk another weekend, bluegrass another weekend, great rock and roll tributes another weekend. You know, just whatever feels right. Whatever feels right.
Right, yeah.
Do it, man. Play some tunes.
This is called Sunshine. Drummers like that's the hit.
I love it. So, seriously. Yeah.
This song is called Serve the Song.
Like a box of memories, some are real and some are make-believe. Most of the time I cannot tell the difference. It's the truth that lies somewhere in between. Sometimes we're here to serve each other. Other times we're here to serve ourselves. But this time, the only thing that's right that isn't wrong, but this time I'm here to serve the song. Scared to put my head down on my pillow until I get these words out on the page. The words are coming to me fast and steady all night long, like water flowing out of a broken main. Well, maybe it'll be different in the morning. That's why I keep writing all night long. For many years, all my words just seem to come out wrong. But this time I'm here to serve the song. Sometimes we're here to serve each other. Other times we're here to serve ourselves. This time, the only thing that's right that isn't wrong. Well, this time, I'm here to serve the song. This time, I'm here to serve the song. This time, I'm here to serve the song.
Thank you very much. Thanks, y'all. Thank you.
That was good. Everything's about the song. So
everything.
It's you so true. Serve the song.
You serve the song. Yeah. It's so true. That's a saying that we have in when we're in the studio recording. Like, do what serves the song properly instead of trying to.
Don't like do like crazy.
Yeah, yeah. Sometimes it's just most of the time it's unnecessary.
Right. Yeah.
Cool. Let's play some covers.
All right. So. I'm going to sing this one first. Greg's going to help me. This is Dead Flowers, which the Dead Flowers have been here a bunch, which is Stone's tribute band, named after this song, obviously. So let's do that.
Let's do it.
One, two, three. Well, when you're sitting there in your silk upholstered chair, talking to some rich folk that you know, I hope you won't see me in my ragged company. You know I could never be alone. Take me down, little Susie, take me down. I know you think you're the queen of the underground. Yeah, you can send me dead flowers every morning. Send me dead flowers by the mail. Send me dead flowers to my wedding, and I won't forget to put roses on your grave. Yeah, when you're sitting back in your rose-paint Cadillac, making bets on Kentucky Derby Day, I'll be in my basement room with a needle and a spoon. And now, girl, take my pain away. Take me down, little
say, take me down. I know you think you're the queen of the underground. Yeah, you can send me dead flowers every morning. Send me dead flowers by the mail. Send me dead flowers to my wedding. And I won't forget to put roses on your grave.
Together before, by the way. Like, we met each other a couple times.
Yep.
We follow each other on Facebook.
Yep.
And here we are.
I love it.
Yeah. So we're doing E flat.
Yeah, you got it.
Start around.
And again, the pleasure has been all mine. Thank you so much for inviting me in for this. It's been fun.
I love to have Greg here. This is amazing. He lives near Cowtown Rodeo, which is actually not that far.
Like four or five miles.
And me and Jason Jonick, if you're out there, we've been to Cowtown a couple times, and we had a good time.
It's the best. If you've never done it, you have to at least once.
Yeah, at least once.
So younger than the sun, and the mining boat was one as we sailed into the misty. Hark, now hear the sailors cry, smell the sea and feel the sky. Let your soul and spirit fly into the misty. When that foghorn blows, I'll be coming home. And when that foghorn whistle blows, I won't feel it. Don't have to fear it, and I wanna rock your gypsy soul, just like way back in the days of old. And together we will flow hand to the mistake. When that foghorn blows, I'll be coming home. Yeah, when that foghorn whistle blows, I wanna hear it. I don't have to fear it, and I won't rock your gypsy soul. Like we're back in the days of old, and magnificently we will float into mystery. Stop now.
Thanks, everybody. Thanks for tuning in at home. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thanks, Andrew.
Wow. Yeah, that was cool. That was very cool. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for your support tonight. KennettFlash.org/donate. It's never too late to make a donation. Maybe you're watching this on the replay. You can still support the Kennett Flash. Thank you so much for the help tonight. I'll remind you, we are back here Saturday, April 17th with Cliff Hillis and Ben Arnold right on that stage. Friday, April 23rd, we'll be back here again with Chip Porter and Mark Unruh. And the kickoff to the Rooftop Concert Series here in Kennett Square is Friday, April 30th with Dave Matic and Funk Tap, and it's on sale now. Thank you so much for tuning in tonight, guys. We'll see you on April 17th. Good night.